Looking to interact with web servers quickly and easily? Then you need cURL post request. Let me explain. cURL is a command line tool that allows data exchange between a device and a server. cURL allows you to make requests through methods such as get, which retrieves data from a server. Meanwhile, post is an HTTP request method that allows you to send data to a server and interact with it. You can send many different post requests, but they always consist of three parts: headers, body, and URL. Headers usually include necessary metadata like content type or authentication details. The body stores the information you send, and the URL specifies the endpoint to which the request is posted. Let's see how this looks when we send a basic cURL request. First, make sure you've installed cURL. It's usually pre-installed on Linux, Windows, and macOS. But if you don't have it, check documentation for step-by-step instructions. Once ready, open your terminal and enter this command to see if cURL is installed on your system. Below, you'll find details of your cURL version. Now, let's target this website designed to test cURL requests. If it goes through, this website will structure and return our posted data. First, we enter the expost option. It specifies that we're sending a post request. Next, we add the URL we're targeting and run the command. We get back a structured JSON response, meaning our request has gone through. While looking at the output, you'll notice it's empty. That's because we didn't send any data and just pinged the server. So, how can we build a more sophisticated request? We start with a header, which should match the data type we're transmitting. Then, we can check the documentation and see that sending data requires a D option. We add it and then list all the values as key value pairs. Last, we enter a URL. Let's replace the example values and send some JSON data to our practice site. Again, we start with the post request object. In headers, we specify that it's a JSON file. Then we create Pokemon, type, and HP keys followed by their values. Enter the URL and run the code. As you can see, the JSON section is now filled in with the data we transmitted. A similar format can be used for XML. Just change the content type and reformat the body to represent an XML file. The same logic applies when you send other types of information. You might want to try uploading files. Then, we'd start with a post request and add an F option. In the quotation marks, specify the file type and add the file path. Then goes our endpoint URL. To send multiple files at once, we simply repeat the F option with different field names and file paths. You may also want to send multiple headers at the same time, especially when dealing with web APIs or performing complex web requests. In this scenario, repeat the H option with your desired header values. Finally, after building your request, you might want to save the response in a separate file. Do this by adding an O option at the end of your request, followed by the text document file path. Make sure to create an empty file beforehand. Just to give you an idea of how post requests work in real projects, take a look at this example. This is a cURL post request copied from our e-commerce scraping API's playground. With this request, will target Amazon search results. Although the request is structured differently than we saw before, it still consists of headers, a body, and a URL. And at the end, we have added an output option to save our results in a file. For the final time, let's run the code. If we open the text file we linked, you can see it also has the same output. That is all you need to know to build and send cURL post requests. Check our video description for a cURL commands cheat sheet. If you find this video helpful, subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you in another video.